everybody for coming. It's wonderful and gratifying to all of the family and very close friends that you're here to celebrate CL's life. It's very supporting to all of us and warm to have this group gathered for CL to honor her. This afternoon we're going to hear her poetry. We're going to listen to stories that you have. We're going to have some movement and some music she loved. Everything in the program has to do with CL. Either she wrote it or she did it. So I'm sure that we'll all feel full of CL by the time we can't get too full, that's for sure. The canvas, CL was so, they were an integral type of part of her life. So we're going to have, we have lots of candles, as you can see. And we're especially going to have her grandchildren, Rye and Oliver and Simone, each light a candle in honor of CL. And see, they were the light of her life, as many of you know. And it's symbolic that they should light the candles that produced warmth for her, light for her. She used them for ceremonies. She used them to honor peoples. She used them to bring in healing, all kinds of things. Candles were an integral part of her life. And she had a storeroom full of candles in her home. So, or more than a storeroom, as some of you know. So if Rye and Oliver and Simone want to come up and light a candle. Jan Frazier will read one of CL's poems, I Must Go North. Such a privilege to be able to say a poem by CL. I must go north. I must go north because winter calls. Dark nights clarify the soul. I will travel light. Pretension has no home here. I am Inanna, stripped bare of all I hide behind. I will go north into what it is I fear. I will find no home, no place where I belong. There are no signposts to guide this solitary journey. I must find the mentor, the one who holds the lantern hidden deep within myself. Within my store of living are memories of light, of southern skies, of laughter, and of joy. These I will gather, one by one, to place upon the altar of this journey. They will walk beside me. They will light the pathway. They will show my feet the way to go. I need a branch to swing from. Let me lift high, then let me fall. One carves forth the other to become the sculpture of my living. When a Chinese calligrapher lifts his brush, It is the space around the ink-black strokes that brings forth the structure he creates. May I tumble through that downward descent with the freedom of a leaf, well-lived and brightly painted, carving down the wind, a day crescendo of delight, singing all the way.
Cielo was someone who created so many circles. And you see so many circles here that I only know this much of, just a little bit. And you realize that the person that was your mother is so much to so many different people around the world. And she touched so many people. And it's such a powerful feeling. And I feel really honored and a little like a kite, to be a little let free right now, like that groundingness that she provides, that center to the circle, that spiral that brings us all into a center, you're cut free. And it's almost an outer body type experience. And I think I want to just thank all that are here for sharing that experience and sharing the experience of her. So much of what she was this intensely personal being, this person who was always pushing herself to go into different places and to combine different things. And she showed me what poetry is and what it can mean in your life. And then she was the person I would come to for the very basic conversations, those very intimate touchbacks on what life was for and how we were doing along those lines. And it was a very personal, mercurial, wonderful relationship in which had all the elements of, you know, everything from a son and to a mother to two people who were just trying to find their path. And I think she did in such a wonderful way, found such a wonderful path. And she was so inspiring, and I'm tremendously inspired by all the love that is pouring out from around the world. People I don't even know were writing me letters saying how much she and then even me meant to them through her, even though I've never met them. And that's just because of Seattle and how much she tied those circles together through her life. So thank you all for being a part of that. And, that's all I have. Thank you.
It might have been quite awful being the shy and mousy daughter of such a radiant, charismatic person as my mother. But Ciel's magnetism came to her so naturally and so unselfconsciously that one could not be diminished by it. It was impossible for her to be anyone other than herself. She had no filter or pretense. Ciel inhabited the realms of intuition, of emotion, the non-linear, the right brain, the mystical, mutable, impulsive, quick. Turn your head and she was gone. She wasn't ditching you. She just was on to the next thing, completely and fully in the next moment. All things art turned to gold in her hands. Movement, acting, singing, photography, visual art, poetry, making art seemed to be a personal imperative. And the discipline with which she researched and studied and taught was impressive. But then juxtaposed to all this rigor was the part of her, though it was always so childlike. Ciel loved to dress up and to play tricks on people. She regularly cheated at card games, stole napkins and silverware from restaurants, exaggerated, and lied. And there were times when I distinctly wished she would grow up. These last 10 to 12 weeks with her have been rich beyond anything I have experienced. Watching her draw on 35 plus years of meditation, Qigong, Tai Chi, to make it through the treatment that she was so determined to get through was astounding. The graciousness with which she accepted help was humbling. The learning from her goes on. And I expect we'll go on for a while.
In hysterics, and sometimes even tinkle in our panties. To give you an idea and share some of the many, many stories, picture the four of us at Hannaford's. One day in the late fall, not many years ago. Now, you wouldn't really think of Hannaford's as a particularly funny place. But as we walked down the center aisle, at the exact same moment, our eyes fell upon an end cap. Halloween costume. If you've heard of any of our madcap escapades, you might guess what came next. In the blink of an eye, the same thought raced between us, except for our sister Gigi. Being the oldest, who always felt the responsibility to rein us in, knowing it was hopeless. Abandoning our cart, we raced toward a glorious variety of witches' hats and wigs, capes and scary masks, and lo and behold, right down the very same aisle, brooms. Are you starting to get the idea? While Gigi hid behind the plants in the floral department, the three of us quickly donned our costumes. Ciel in a hobbit mask and witch's hat as tall as she was. Genia in a princess crown and flowing stars. And me, a devil mask and long red tail. Mounting our brooms, we raced past startled customers. Some averted their eyes, unable to imagine what three somewhat elderly women possibly could be up to. Others allowed a brief smile to cross their lips, which only spurred us on. Through the canned veggies we raced, down the baking aisle, around the potatoes, past the tomatoes, to where Chi-Chi hid among the ferns. Gleefully we circled her, bubble, 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 we chanted, while she batted us away, hissing admonitions to stop this outrageous behavior. Not to be deterred, we galloped past more startled people at the checkout stand, looped around the pharmacy, and came to a halt back by the brooms. Exhausted, we dismounted and returned them to their proper place for their proper use. Quietly, we replaced our costumes, and with a knowing smile upon our face, our craziness completed. We sedately pushed our cart past the bread and crackers, three somewhat elderly women doing their shopping.
Yeah.
we have some sobering music. Beautiful music from Bach, and Sabine Frein is going to play.
It is such an honor to read a poem by C.L. Devotion. At 10, I was a devotee of every waking minute. There was worship in each day's beginning, relish in each present moment. Memories were few. And so it was pain. Sky and sun, taste, touch, and unexamined joy burned away all hindrance to a body stretched and taut with living. At 19, I was a devotee of ignited love. And it flamed for more than 40 years. It burns me still in dreams. Oh, when I see a long forgotten photo, or I think I hear his voice just past my ear. I would fly to my children at the slightest call, and I will still, though they now hold more years than my own when I gave them life. I found my craft at 30, and more than 3 decades hence, it fills my early hours of every day. I find 4 qualities that define devotion: presence, passion, discipline, and a humbling reverence. My worship needs them all. But it is the passion first that brings the others in its wake. It lifts my wings to let me fly.
first two, we are going, and Becky's going to lead us in singing together, bringing our voices together.
Y'all love this song right enough, and I do too. It was written during apartheid South Africa, and it speaks of hope and courage, of clear eyes, of moving forward with energy through change and struggle. I find in it dedication, graceful interior strength, mystery, and wonder. What song could be better to sing for CL than this? So we're going to sing just the top part of the words you have three times. First time in unison, so that people who might not know it yet get a chance to know it. And then the next two in harmony. And everyone should sing, even if they don't know it and are going to mess up the whole time. And if you want to sing harmony, but you don't know it, there's a very easy harmony part. It's called the fancy part, which means that it stays on one note the whole time. We are going, heaven knows where we are going.
Like that?
We'll do that when we get to the harmony. But first, we'll sing the melody.
We know we win, and we will get it.
We plan to try and keep this as brief and together as we can so that there won't be an opportunity for everybody to come up and talk about CL. But there, out on the table in the foyer, there's sort of a scrapbook thing with different colored paper, and we would love it if you would at least leave your name and email and maybe just a hello, or tell a long story or a vignette about CL. That would be wonderful. That will be instead of a guest book, and much more important and meaningful, I hope. And we hope that you will enjoy this time and know that all your thoughts and stories we want to hear, and you'll share them with each other over wine and food and some chocolates. I understand chocolates are on the menu, lots of them. Share your stories, the ones you wish you were up here to tell us.